Hi, I'm Arjun Pachati, INR Bonds. Welcome to Let's Talk Bonds, the weekly podcast from INR Bonds, where we talk about the options available for investors in the bond market, where they can invest their fixed income savings, which they need to allocate as part of their overall portfolio allocation. And with this, with the very low yields returns that investors are getting in fixed income markets, the biggest trend is moving towards what is called market-linked debentures, or MLDs as they call it. This market has grown to be very, very big. It is seeing issuances from across all segments of issuers in various structures. You have equity-linked MLDs, where the returns are based on what happens to the Nifty index or any other equity indices. And you have the fixed bond MLDs, where the returns are linked to a G-Sec. And all these MLDs are also, many investors look to them as an instrument that enables them to pay capital gains tax rather than take the full brunt of the slab which is available on bonds, as bonds our interest is fully charged on the taxation side. Now, but just before we start on the MLDs, we'll just run through what are the yields available in the market for investors across all the instruments. So government bond yields are anywhere between 4.4% to 7.25% for the 40-year bond. Now, the 10-year benchmark bond is around 6.55%. The 5-year bond is around 6%, while the 15-year bond is around 7%. And state development loans that are yield better than government bonds are around trading at around 7.1%, 0.15%. And for investors looking to invest in PSU bonds, which is the safest category of bonds, which is outside the government bonds, which is through the Bharat Bond ETF. The Bharat Bond ETF is anywhere between 4.85% for 1 year ETF maturing in February 2023 to the 10-year Bharat Bond ETF that was recently launched. That is trading at 7.07%, 7.07%. Still very, all these levels are still very, very low for investors, especially if you look at it from an inflation adjusted perspective. And many of them do not even compensate for the inflation levels that is running in the economy. So in corporate bond side, you have the top rated papers like HDFC and Bajaj Finance for 3-year papers around 6 to 6.2%. The 5-year is closer to around 7%, slightly higher. And the 5 and 10-year will go out to around 7.5 to 7.6%. And many other issuers, which are highly rated, including Mahindra Finances and Tata Clean Techs of the world, which is into clean energy of the Tata Group. These are all Tata Clean Tech also would be an ESG investment, which many investors prefer nowadays. And these are all still for longer maturity bonds, which is 5 to 7 years, yet around 7.7% levels. So if you go for the top rated papers, either you have, again, the maturities are longer for higher yields. And if you go for short maturities, the yields are very low, as we see in the Bharat Bond ETF, which is just about 4.9%. And in the mutual, obviously, liquid funds are offering anything below around 4%. And all the other funds are in the range of around 5 to 6.5% in terms of portfolio yields, and which is really not offering too much for investors again. And especially with interest rates looking to rise, the options seem to be extremely limited now. Either you sacrifice returns or you have to go in for longer maturity papers to take interest rate risk. If you go down the rating scale, you have microfinance companies which are closer to 10%, 9 to 10%. And then you have other companies, other bonds, including bonds like TVS Credit, which is two-year bond at around 8.5%. And new issuers like Navi Finserv, which is a one-year bond, is around 9.2% and above. So all these, obviously, you have to understand what kind of credit risk you're taking on these bonds. If you are able to have your financial advisors able to advise you on the investments in higher rated bonds of 2 to 3 year kind of maturity, yielding anywhere between 8.5 to 10%. And if you're comfortable with the risk, then the levels are much more attractive. But again, the compromise here is that you go down the credit rating scale. Now let's come back to MLDs. So MLDs, like I said, are market-linked dimensions, and these are finding a huge amount of flavor for investors. More and more wealth managers and investment bankers and others are issuing MLDs to attract investors. Because one is for ultra high net worth in the 40% bracket, they are able to bypass some kind of taxation, so get better returns on their investments in fixed income. And for many who are a little worried about equity market volatility, they are able to take calls on whether they're able to protect themselves against volatility in the equity indices and still get returns. If there are some certain targets on Nifty and other indices are achieved. So MLDs are gaining, some of the prominent MLDs issuers include Anand Rathi Financial, Global Finance. Then you have many MLDs that are issued by regular borrowers like Shriram Group. Then you have many microfinance companies, including Muthoot Microfinance, Ashirwad Microfinance, all are floating MLDs. You have infrastructure companies floating MLDs. You have other NBFCs like Edelweiss offering MLDs. So MLDs seem to be even Navi Finserv is doing MLDs. So MLDs seem to be the flavor of the day. And more and more, like I was saying, the market is growing bigger and bigger in size as more and more wealth managers and issuers are pushing MLDs. As far as the retail investors go, the MLDs offer them, like I said, a bit of tax advantage, higher yields on fixed income, and protection against volatility in equity markets. But they still take on the credit risk of the issuer. While for the issuer, they are able to raise funds at lower yields, given that MLDs are seeing good amount of demand. And investment bankers are approaching companies to issue MLDs rather than plain vanilla bonds. Each has got its own quirks. MLDs have issue of pricing, especially equity-linked MLDs. And they may not be as liquid as regular plain vanilla bonds because MLDs are only invested in the retail investor market, not in the wholesale debt market. So there are investors would have to understand what MLDs are all about. And INR bonds has a whole host of content, which is knowledge-based content on MLDs, including YouTube videos and including a lot of research which we have put out on MLDs in terms of structure and pricing, etc. So investors looking to invest in INR bonds in MLDs can come to INR bonds and check out all that knowledge content. Yep, that's it for this week. And we are very happy to announce the launch of our app, the Quick Invest from INR Bonds app. The Quick Invest app is an app which you can download for Android and iOS users. And this app will enable you to invest in corporate bonds with the most information, we give a curated list of bonds, and it we make the app made it very simple for you to understand and invest in bonds through a straight through simplified process of investment without cluttering your without cluttering your investment decision. So please download the app from our from your Play Stores, whether you're an Android or an iOS user, and start to use a quick invest from INR Bonds. And we have all full support functions for you to invest in, along with a lot of knowledge that gives you all the uncorks all the terminology that is there in the by investments in bonds. And this will help you invest in and take better investment decisions in bonds, so that your fixed income investments can work for you across all kinds of investment environments. Thank you for listening in, and do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you have not done so already.